Alright, so I'm going to show you how we can sketch some bubbles that we will turn into some interactive artwork. So what I'm going to start with is I'm going to start with where the handle and the kind of loop of the bubbles would be. Alright, so I'm just going to start with a line going off the bottom that's going to be about the same thickness as a pencil, because I am actually going to secretly attach this to a pencil. Alright, so I'm just going to have that come up some. And then I know that a bubble wand tends to be circle shaped, but on the inside there are some jagged edges because that is the tension that helps get the bubble. Alright, so then from my bubble, if I was blowing into this, I would see it come out and stretch and then right back to the bottom. Right? And I could pretend like I already blew some bubbles and I could draw some more circles. And for these circles, if you want, you could get an object and trace a circle. Or you could just try to draw some circles. So I'm going to trace a few things that I have just near me. Right, so giant container of paint. Alright, that was my smaller paint. I'm going to go with the bottom of my water cup. Yes, I painted recently, so my water cup has very dirty water in it. Alright, but I could also add some smaller circles as well. Remember, if you want to trace something that is a circle, you can. Alright, I'm going to make this circle look like it's a little bit behind the other circle. And another circle as well. And one of the key things about bubbles is that they're actually clear, but you have some reflections of different light and colors. So I'm going to start just by the edges, because in bubbles I notice that that's where it reflects the most, and I'm going to press a little bit harder towards the very edge and then go a little bit lighter as I get towards the middle. And I'm going to keep a blue highlight, I think. I'm going to just try to do that on all my bubbles in kind of the same spot. Alright, so I'm just adding some blue highlight on all my bubbles. And then I'm going to think, well, what other colors do I see when I look at a bubble? Because sometimes I think I see little rainbows in them. So I'm going to think of another color that I could add. So I'm going to add a little bit of pink. Alright, so maybe I have a little bit of pink coming from opposite side. Alright, and again I'm doing the same thing where I'm going to press a little bit harder towards the outside and a little bit lighter as I get towards the middle. And bubbles are actually pretty tricky, so I'm just going to try the best that I can to make it look like what I would think it would look like. Alright, I'm going to add a little bit of yellow next to my blues. Because I want these to end up being pretty colorful. Alright, bubbles do tend to have highlights in them though. And highlights are where the sun is reflecting or the light is reflecting, so I do need to make sure that I leave some spots blank white, because that is where the highlight would be. I'm going to add a little bit of luscious lavender or purple to my bottoms. And I hope they're starting to look a little bit like they could be bubbles. I'm giving myself, I know I'm doing it very lightly, just these small rectangles up on the top right of all of these. And they're a little bit curved. And I'm gonna think that's where my highlights are, so I really don't want to color inside of that. All right, I'm gonna think what other colors I am missing from my rainbow. And one color I'm missing right now, if I was thinking about the colors of the rainbow, is some orange. So I'm gonna put some orange right next to my pink. Maybe have it go a little close to my yellow. Because I know that red and yellow make orange. And again, you could use whatever colors you want. One thing that is going to be key to making it look like a bubble is that it should have a bunch of white in it, but also that you need that highlight that's going to make it look like this light is shining off of it. All right, and I'm just going to add a little bit of green right by my purple. My little circles are even more colorful than my big circles because I'm running out of space. I am by no means a bubble expert, but I am trying my best. And so after I add some details, then I can think what color bubble wand I might want. And I'm going to use a color that is probably going to be the same color as whatever I'm going to attach this to. So I'm going to think about, well, what can I attach this to create the illusion that I am blowing bubbles. So I'm going to go with a purple because I think this would look cool if I used a purple paintbrush. You could use a pencil, you could use a straw, you could use a chopstick, you could use a pen, whatever you have. And we have some bubbles. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to be cutting this out some, but I'm not going to cut right next to everything. So I'm going to draw a line, and just so you can see it a little bit more clearly, I'm going to make my line this berry color for where I'm going to cut. So I'm going to cut a little bit outside of my bubble. I'm not going to cut this bubble off. I'm going to keep coming around the outside of all my bubbles. So all my bubbles will end up being attached to this same piece of paper. I don't really want to cut them apart. I want them to stay together. So that's why I'm starting with drawing this outline so I know exactly where to cut. So now I am going to cut along that line.